इन क्लास नाइन्थ वी हैव द चैप्टर द सेवन्थ चैप्टर वी हैव एज ट्राइंगल्स एंड इन दैट चैप्टर वी हैव लर्न समथिंग अबाउट द कॉन्ग्रुएंट फिगर्स और द कॉन्ग्रुएंट ट्राइंगल्स. व्हेन टू ट्राइंगल्स आर कॉन्ग्रुएंट देन वी हैव द फोर क्राइटेरियाज फॉर कॉन्ग्रुएंसी. द फर्स्ट वन वी हैव SSS. इफ ऑल द साइड्स आर इक्वल देन द टू ट्राइंगल्स आर कॉन्ग्रुएंट. Then the second one we have SAS. Third one we have ASA and the fourth one we have RHS. Then in class 10th we have the sixth chapter as triangle and here we have the concept of similar figure or similar triangles. Little bit difference between these two we have the congruent and the similar figure and that we are going to discuss in this presentation. And a very important theorem we are getting in this as the Thales theorem or the basic proportionality theorem. This is similar to the midpoint theorem which we have learnt in class 9th. Then let us start this. Then similar figure. Two figures having the same shape but not necessarily the same size. Two figures having same shape, this is necessary, but if the size may differ, then that two figures are similar figure. The second point is most important. All congruent figures are similar. In class 9th, we have learnt about congruent triangle, and if we have proved any two triangles congruent, then yes, that two triangles are similar also. But all similar figures are not congruent. One marks question we are getting on the concept of that. Then here we have the similar polygon. Two polygons are said to be similar to each other if the corresponding angles are equal and the length of their corresponding sides are proportional. If you are considering any polygon, and what do you know about the polygon? Polygon is a closed figure having three or more than three sides. Then the corresponding angles are equal or the sides are proportional, then we are able to tell yes, that two polygons are similar to each other. Here we have the concept of line segments. If I am considering here, if I am taking a line segment and the first one I am taking as length 3 cm, and the L2 I am taking having length 6 cm. Then these two are proportional. And if these two are proportional, then we are able to tell yes, these two line segments are similar to each other. Same if you are observing here, the circles we are getting having the different radii R1, R2. If you are considering R1 as 2 cm. And R2 as 4 cm. Then yes, these two circles are similar. Having different radii, but the radii are proportional. If the radii are proportional, we are able to tell yes, the circles are similar. Means all the circles are similar. Here if you are observing, then we are getting a square. And if the square we have, then all the angles we know for each and every square we are getting a right angle. And these two squares are similar to each other because their corresponding angles are equal and the length are proportional. In this figure, if you are observing the two triangles, you are getting ABC and PQR. And when these two triangles are similar, if these corresponding angles are equal and these sides, the corresponding sides are proportional, then we are able to tell the triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR. And the similar sign, if you are observing, then here we are writing ट्रायंगल ए बी सी सिमिलर टू ट्रायंगल पी क्यू आर। वेन वी आर राइटिंग कॉन्ग्रेंसी देन वी आर यूजिंग इक्वल टू सिंबल ऑन बिलो दिस वेव, बट वेन वी आर राइटिंग अ सिमिलरिटी देन ओनली वी आर यूजिंग दिस वेव सिंबल। Now let us discuss the Thales theorem or the basic proportionality theorem. And what we are getting? Statement is given. Try to learn the statement. If a line is drawn parallel to one side of a triangle to intersect the other two sides in distinct point, then the other two sides are divided in the same ratio. If a line is drawn parallel to one side of a triangle to intersect the other two sides in distinct point, the other two sides are divided in the same ratio. This we are going to prove. Then here if you are observing a triangle, then I am taking a triangle ABC and in this DE is parallel to BC. This is given. And here I am drawing the perpendicular. DN is perpendicular to AC and EM is perpendicular to AB. And also I am joining BE and CD for proving this. What we have to prove, DE is parallel to BC, it means that we have to show the ratio AD upon BD is equal to AE upon EC. Then let us prove this. And when we are proving any theorem, then we are writing these values given, we have to write. And what is given? In triangle ABC, DE is parallel to BC. This is given. What we have to prove? We have to show this AD upon DB is equal to AE upon EC. These two sides are proportional. For proving this, what we are drawing? We are drawing two perpendiculars, EM perpendicular AD and DN perpendicular AE. Then we are joining B to E and C to D. After keeping all these things in mind, what we are observing? We are observing the triangle and the area of triangle we are able to find. Area of triangle is half base into height. And if you are using this concept, area of triangle ADE upon area of triangle BDE. If you are going to find the ratio of the areas of these two triangles, then for the triangle ADE, one time you are getting the base as AD and one time you are getting the base as AE. Then here I am using the base AD and I am getting half AD into EM. For triangle BDE, the perpendicular is same. For this reason, we are getting half DB into EM. Then on solving, half half get cancelled out, EM EM get cancelled out, and we are getting AD upon DB. Let this be equation first. Then in this triangle, if you are going to find the ratios of the areas of triangle ADE and CDE, and this time I am going to take the perpendicular as DN. Then this perpendicular is for AE and for EC also. Then let us find the ratios of the areas of triangle ADE and triangle CDE. Then we are getting as half AE into DN, and area of triangle CDE we are getting half EC into DN. Half half get cancelled out, DN DN get cancelled out, and we are getting the ratio as AE upon EC. And D is parallel to BC also. And what we know in class 9th, we have a theorem: if the triangles you are getting on the same base and between same parallel, then that two triangles are equal in areas. And what we are observing in the diagram, if you are observing BDE, triangle BDE and triangle CDE, these two triangles are on the same base and between the parallel DE parallel BC, It means that yes, these two are equal in areas. For this reason, here we are taking area of triangle BDE is equal to area of triangle CDE. Let this be equation second. And if you are observing equation first and second, then in the left hand side you are getting the ratios of the areas of triangle. In the first one we are getting area of triangle ADE upon area of triangle CDE, and in this we are getting the ratio as area of triangle ADE upon area of triangle CDE. And what we know, area of triangle AD is, we are getting in the numerator in both the equation, and in the denominator that we are getting, and that two are equal in areas also. It means that from first and second equation we are able to write this, these two, we are able to write AD upon DB is equal to AE upon EC. Then this we have to show. And here I am taking some question on the basis of the Thales theorem. Then in question number first, if you are observing, a diagram is given, and in this figure, in the first one, AD is given to you 1.5, BD is given 3 cm, AE is given 1 cm, and you have to find EC. And if DE is parallel to BC, then we know by basic proportionality theorem we are getting AD upon BD is equal to AE upon CE. And if you are using this side's proportionality, then what we are getting? We are getting as 1.5 upon 3 is equal to AE is 1, EC we are taking as X. Then on cross multiplication we are getting 3 upon 1.5, and on solving these we are getting X equal to 2. It means that the length of EC is, we have 2 cm. Let us solve question number 3rd here. In this figure, LM is parallel to BC, and if LM is parallel to BC, then by basic proportionality theorem we are getting the ratio of AM upon MB, or you are calling as AM upon AB is equal to AL upon AC. And if LN is parallel to CD, then we are getting the ratio as AN upon AD is equal to AL upon AC. This vertex is D. Then if in this triangle you are using basic proportionality theorem in triangle ABC, then we are getting the ratio as AM upon AB is equal to AL upon AC. Let this be equation first. And from the another triangle, if you are considering LN is parallel to CD, then we are getting the ratio as AN upon AD is equal to AL upon AC. Let this be equation second. And from first and second, we are getting AM upon AB is equal to AN upon AD. This we have to show. Let us solve question number 5. In this figure, DE is parallel to OQ. DE is parallel to OQ. Then in triangle POQ, we are getting the sides proportional. PE upon EQ is equal to PD upon OD. And if DF is parallel to OR, then we are able to write PF upon FR is equal to PD upon OD. And from first and second, what we are observing, we are getting these two ratio equal. PE upon EQ is equal to PF upon FR. And if these sides are proportional, then by the converse of basic proportional theorem, you have to do the proof of converse of basic proportionality theorem also. Then we are able to write, yes, EF is parallel to QR. And this we are going to show. Then let us show this. In this triangle, if ED is parallel to OQ, then we are able to write this by basic proportionality theorem. PE upon EQ is equal to BD upon OD. Let this be equation first. Then the next triangle, in triangle POR, if DF is parallel to OR, then we are able to write PF upon FR is equal to PD upon OD. Then this ratio we are getting by basic proportionality theorem. Let this be equation second. And from first and second, what we are getting? We are getting the ratio as PE upon EQ is equal to PF upon FR. And if this we have, then by the converse of basic proportionality theorem, we are able to tell EF is parallel to QR. This we have to show. Let us solve one more question. Question number 9 from the first, second exercise. ABCD is a trapezium in which AB is parallel to DC. This is given. And its diagonals intersect each other at point O. And what we have to show? We have to show this. AO upon BO is equal to CO upon DO. Now let us solve this. Here we are observing a trapezium in which AB is parallel to CD. Here we are doing a construction for proving this. We are drawing a line EF which is parallel to AB. It means that EF is parallel to CD also. And then we are going to choose the triangle. Then in triangle ADC, if EO is parallel to CD, then by basic proportionality theorem, we are getting AE upon ED is equal to AO upon OC. And in triangle ABD, if you are considering OE is parallel to AB, then by basic proportionality theorem, we are getting ED upon AE is equal to OD upon BO. And this can be written as AE upon ED is equal to BO upon OD. Let this be equation second. And from first and second, what we are getting? We are getting AO upon OC is equal to BO upon OD. Then on cross multiplication, we are able to write this value as AO upon BO is equal to OC upon OD. This we have to show in this question. Very easy questions these are. Solve all the questions in the FAIR notebook from the exercise 6.1 and 6.2. Some questions I have done. Sai Ram to all.